टुडे क्लास इज अबाउट इलेक्ट्रीशियन वर्क, इलेक्ट्रिकल वायरिंग कंपोनेंट्स एंड एक्सेसरीज, इंट्रोडक्शन, इलेक्ट्रिसिटी रिक्वायर्स एन इलेक्ट्रिक पाथ टू फॉलो एंड देयर आर मेनी कंडक्टिंग मेटेरियल्स यूज्ड फॉर दिस पर्पज. देयर आर मेनी सेमी कंडक्टिंग मेटेरियल्स विच आर used to reduce the voltage and also drop the current flow. There are non-conducting materials which are used as insulation during working on live lines. In this unit, we will study how the household or industrial wiring is done and what materials are essential for household or industrial wiring. We will also study the different types of wiring and how they is done. Session 1. Identifying and selecting the wiring materials and components. Wiring materials. Electrical wiring is made of materials like copper, aluminium and silver. As silver is expensive, mostly copper and aluminium are used in wiring. Materials are classified into three types according to their properties. Conducting materials, insulating materials, semiconductor materials. Conducting materials. A. Copper. It is a good conductor of electricity. It is used in wiring materials, in cables. It has low resistance and is used for conducting of electricity at high, medium and low voltage. Figure 3.2. It is used in wiring and cable making. B. Aluminium. It is lightweight and cheaper in comparison to copper. Therefore, this type of conducting materials is mostly used in electrical wiring. It is silvery white in color, and it has a soft texture. It is often used in writing and making cables. It is often used in wiring and making cable. Figure 3.3. Aluminium wire. Insulating materials. Insulating materials are used for insulating purpose. These types of material are bad conductor of current. For example, rubber, paper, mica, wood, glass and cotton. Wiring accessories. Wiring accessories are used for connecting appliances. Figure 3.4. These are appliances. Connecting appliances. A. Switch. A switch is used to make or break an electrical circuit. It is used to switch on or off the supply of electricity to an appliance. There are various switches such as surface switch, flush switch, ceiling switch, pull switch, push button switch, bed switch. Surface switch. It is mounted on wooden board fixed on the surface of a wall. It is of three types. 1. One-way switch. 2. Two-way switch. 3. Intermediate switch.
one-way switch. It is used to control single circuits and lamps. Figure 3.5. This is one-way switch. Two-way switch. It is used to divert the flow of current to either or two directions. The two-way switch can also be used to control one lamp from two different places, as in the case of staircase wiring. Figure 3.6. Two-way switch. Intermediate switch. It is used to control a lamp from more than two locations. Figure 3.7. Intermediate switch. 1. Flush switch. It is used for decorative purpose. Figure 3.8. This is flush switch. 2. Back switch. As the name indicates, it is used to switch on the light from any place other than switch board or from near the bed. This switch is connected through a flexible wire. Figure 3.9. This is back switch. Figure 3.9. B. Holders. A holder is of two types. 1. Pendant holders. Figure 3.10. Pendant holder. 2. Button holder. Figure 3.11. This is button holder. 3.11. C. Ceiling rose. It is used to provide a taping to the pendant lamp holder through the flexible wire or a connection to a fluorescent tube. Figure 3.12. D. Socket. 3.12. This is 3.12. Ceiling rose. D. Socket outlet plug. The socket outlet has an insulated base with the molded or socket base having three terminal sleeves. Figure 3.13. This is socket. E. Main switch. To control the electrical circuit, a main switch is used through the main switch. The power in a building is controlled completely. Figure 3.14. This is main switch. Main MSB. F. PVC. Casing caping wiring. F. PVC. Casing caping wiring. PVC capping is done in order to cover the wire. It includes casing also. This casing caping wiring is also known as open wiring, as it is done outside the wall. Material required for PVC casing caping wiring. Figure 3.15 and Figure 3.16 include. This is figure 3.15. PVC casing capping accessories. These are casing capping accessories. Figure 3.16. PVC casing capping band. 1. Wire. 2. Casing enclosure made up of plastic. 3. Capping made up of plastic. 4. T-joint VIR vulcanized Indian rubber or PVC polyvinyl chloride
क्लोराइड इंसुलेटेड वायर, 5 जंक्शन बॉक्स, 6 एल्बो, 7 कैसिंग एंड कैपिंग जॉइंट्स, वुडन कैसिंग एंड कैपिंग वायरिंग इज ऑल फैशनड, नाउ पीवीसी और पीआईआर इंसुलेटेड वायर्स आर इंक्लोज्ड विदिन द पीवीसी कैसिंग इंक्लोजर एंड पीवीसी कैपिंग इज यूज्ड टू कवर द कैसिंग. एडवांटेजेस ऑफ कैसिंग कैपिंग वायरिंग, इजी टू इंस्टॉल, स्ट्रॉन्ग एंड ड्यूरेबल वायरिंग, कस्टमाइजेशन कैन बी डन इजली, सेफ फ्रॉम स्मोक डस्ट रेन एंड स्टीम एक्सेट्रा, नो रिस्क ऑफ शॉक ड्यू टू कैसिंग एंड कैपिंग. डिसएडवांटेजेस ऑफ पीवीसी कैसिंग कैपिंग वायरिंग, कॉस्टली नॉट सुटेबल फॉर ह्यूमिड वेदर, हाई रिस्क ऑफ फायर, मिनिएचर सर्किट ब्रेकर एमसीबी, मिनिएचर सर्किट ब्रेकर एमसीबी, और एमसीबी इज यूज्ड इन न्यू कंस्ट्रक्शंस इंस्टेड ऑफ द ओल्डर टाइप्स ऑफ फ्यूजेस. सर्किट ब्रेकर्स आर स्मॉल डिवाइसेस यूज्ड टू कंट्रोल एंड प्रोटेक्ट द इलेक्ट्रिकल पैनल एंड द अदर डिवाइसेस फ्रॉम ओवरफ्लोइंग ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल पावर्स, फिगर 3.17. दिस इज फिगर 3.17 एमसीबी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन बॉक्स. यूज ऑफ एमसीबी होम इलेक्ट्रिकल पैनल्स, एज विथ ऑल ब्रिकर्स द एमसीबी इज डिजाइंड टू प्रोटेक्ट द हाउस फ्रॉम सर्किट ओवरलोड एंड एमसीबी इज मच सेफर. देन द टिपिकल फ्यूज बिकॉज इट कैन बी रीसेट मैनुअली एंड कैन हैंडल लार्जर अमाउंट ऑफ पावर. द ब्रेकर कैन मैनेज द फ्लो ऑफ एनर्जी डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिंग द वोल्टेज इवन व्हेन मेनी डिवाइसेस रन ऑफ द सेम पावर सर्किट. लाइट्स एमसीबीज आर यूज्ड इन द लाइटिंग सिस्टम ऑफ द हाउस बिकॉज दे कैन डील विथ द अमाउंट ऑफ पावर नीडेड टू लाइटिंग अ हाउस, स्पेशली इफ स्पेसिफिक टाइप ऑफ लैंप्स सच एज फ्लोरोसेंट लाइट्स आर यूज्ड. एमसीबीज ओवरकम द नीड ऑफ एडिशनल पावर रिक्वायर्ड व्हेन स्विचेस ऑन द लाइट्स, स्पेशली व्हेन लाइट्स आर यूज्ड एक्सटेंसिवली इन द इंटायर हाउस. इंडस्ट्रियल एप्लीकेशंस, देयर आर मेनी स्मॉल स्केल इंडस्ट्रियल बिल्डिंग्स वेयर एमसीबीज आर यूज्ड इंस्टेड ऑफ द ओल्ड फ्यूज. मिनिएचर सर्किट ब्रेकर्स आर लार्जली यूज्ड इन रेस्टोरेंट्स, बेकरीज एंड कमर्शियल फूड स्टोर्स. हीटर्स, व्हेन अ हीटर आर यूज्ड एट होम और इन द ऑफिस द एमसीबी कैन बी बेनिफिशियल. इट इज नोन इन जनरल दैट हीटर्स कैन बी प्रॉब्लमेटिक समटाइम्स, स्पेशली विथ डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल पावर. द एमसीबी प्रिवेंट्स पॉसिबल प्रॉब्लम्स कटिंग ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इन द केस ऑफ ओवरलोड और फॉल्ट. इन दिस केस थ्रू यू नीड टू चूज अ मिनिएचर सर्किट ब्रेकर ऑफ द proper capacity, enabling it to handle the load of power when needed. Conduit wiring. Electrical conduits are used to protect and provide the root of electrical wiring in an electrical system. Electrical conduits are made of metal, plastic or fiber and can be rigid or flexible. Conduits, figure 3.18 and 3.19 must. This is figure 3.18, conduit wiring must be installed by a electrician as per standard regulations. For workshops and public buildings, conduit wiring is the best and most desirable system of wiring. It provides protection and safety against fire. Types of conduits. 1. Class A conduits, thin layered steel sheet of low gauge. 2. Class B conduit, thick steel sheet of high gauge. Material used in conduit wiring. GI, galvanized iron wire. Elbow, coupling wire, vulcanized Indian rubber or PVC, polyvinyl chloride, insulated cables, lock nut, clip, junction box. Advantages of conduit wiring: safe, better appearance, no risk of fire, no risk of damage of cable insulation, safe from humidity, smoke, steam, etc., no risk of shock, long lasting. Disadvantages of conduit wiring: expensive, installation is not easily customizable for future use, hard to detect faults. Two-way conduits, one-way conduits, three-way conduits, 3.19 conduits wiring components. Concealed wiring. It is laborious to install this wiring. The layout of this wiring is done under the plastic of the wall of the building. Advantages of concealed wiring: safe, better appearance, no risk of fire, no risk of damage of cable insulation, safe for humidity, smoke, steam, etc., no risk of shock, long lasting. Disadvantages of concealed wiring: expensive, installation is not easily customizable for future use, hard to detect faults. Color code. Wiring for AC and DC circuits are colored code for identification of individual wires. Table 3.1. AC power circuits wiring color codes. Function.
protective ground level PG, new color green or green yellow, old color green, natural N, new color white, old color gray. Line single phase L, black and or red, all color black, blank. Line three phase L1, black, brown. Line three phase L2, red, earlier it was orange. Line three phase L3, blue, earlier it was yellow. Check your progress. A, fill in the blanks. Wiring materials is of three types. And two, a switch is used to make or break. Three, open wiring is also known as wiring. Four, are devices used to control and protect the electrical panel from overflowing electrical powers. B, state whether the following statements are true or false. One, silver is a bad conductor of electricity. Two, switches are made of conducting material. 3. PVC casing and caping are used for covering the wires. C. Multiple choice question. 1. Concealed wiring is immune to A. Humidity, B. Heat, C. Light, D. Dust. 2. Pendant holders is used for A. Flexing the bulb, B. Fixing the bulb, B. Fixing the fan, C. For hanging the bulb, D. To hang the fan. 3. A two-way switch is used for A. Control one bulb from two points, B. Control two bulbs from two points, C. Control multiple bulbs from two points, D. Control one bulb from one point. D. Short answer question. 1. Why is PVC casing capping preferred over wooden casing capping wiring? 2. How does an MCB help in managing electrical power? 3. Why is conduit wiring used in homes? D. Discuss the importance of color codes in electrical wiring. Session 2. ICTP switches and distribution board. ICTP, iron clad triple pole. ICTP, iron clad triple pole switch. It is used along with the energy meter to isolate the supply of electricity automatically or manually. Figure 3.20. Figure 3.20. ICTP switches. These are ICTP switches. Distribution board. A distribution board is a component of an electricity supply system that divides an electrical power feed into subsidiary circuits. While providing a protective fuse or circuit breaker for each circuit in a common enclosure. A distribution board is also known as panel board, breaker panel or electric panel. Figure 3.21. This is figure 3.21. MCB distribution board. This is MCB distribution board. Electrical circuit. In an electrical circuit, the positive side of wire is connected to the negative side of a load. For example, bulb, TV, etc. And power supply is started by using a switch. The circuit is like an electrical house. Types of circuit. 1. Open. 3. Closed. 4. Series. 5. Parallel. Series circuit. It is like a staircase. In this type of circuit, R1, R2, R3 are resistance connected in series. In this, R equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3, where R is equivalent to resistance. Parallel circuit. When various resistance are connected in parallel, then it is called a parallel circuit. Like if R1, R2 and R3 are connected in a parallel, then 1/R equal to 1/R1 + 1/R2 + 1/R3. In this, all resistance having positive sides are connected on one end and all negative sides are connected on another end. In this, voltage are same in all the branches. Fixing wiring accessories on board. You should know the tools required for fixing the accessories on the board. You should also know the purpose of fixing the accessories. In-house wiring of the switches, holders and sockets should be fixed on wooden sunmica board and blocks. Therefore, it is necessary to learn how to fix these accessories. The way to fix these accessories have been discussed in the following practical activity. Let's practice one. Adjust the electrical accessory like switches, holders, sockets, etc. on the given board or round blocks, and then mark their position by a pencil. Remove the covers of the accessory and loosen the screws of terminals. Make a powder of chalk and pour it in the holes of the terminal. Mark the point on them by the poker. Now make the hole on the round block or board by the drilling machine. Where the point have been marked, insert the wire in the terminal. After removing the insulation, then fix all the accessories on the board or round block by wooden
screws after making holes on them by the poker. Then fix all covers on the accessories. Tools and materials required. Tools: 1. Hand drilling machine with a drift bit of 5 cm. 2. Poker. 3. Screwdriver. 4. Connector screwdriver 8 cm. 5. Combination plier 15 cm. 6. Tri square. 7. Firmer chisel 20 mm. 7. Firmer chisel 20 mm. 8. Electrician knife 10 cm. Materials: 1. Wooden round block, PVC round block. 2. Wooden board, sun mica board. 3. Single pole, one way switch, 5A, 250 voltage. 4. PVC wire, 5 pencil, 6 chalk. Precautions: all the fittings, switch holder should be fitted well. No necked portion of the conductor should remain visible. The screws in the accessories fitted should be tight. The tools should be used carefully. Single way switch. How to control a lamp from two different places by two-way switch? S1 SPDT 2-way, S2 SPDT 2-way. Two-way switches, intermediate switch, two-way switch, lamp. A lamp is switched on and switched off from three different places. Practical exercise, activity 1. Aim. Identify and draw the figure of various wiring materials. Procedure: see the different type of wiring materials as shown in the diagram as well as in classroom and draw the diagram. Activity 2. M. Identify and connect the accessory with the wires, tools and equipment required. 1. Multimeter for measuring the current and voltage. 2. Tools like plier, screwdriver will be required. Procedure: accessory will be connected with the help of wires. Precautions: 1. All connections should be tight. 2. Do not touch the terminals when supply is on. Activity 3. Aim. To connect different type of components with wire in a junction box. Tools and equipment required. 1. Multimeter. 2. Tools like screwdriver, plier. Procedure: 1. Different type of components will be connected with the help of wires in a junction box. Precautions: 1. All connections should be tight. 2. Do not touch the terminals when supply is on. Question and answers. State whether the following are true or false. 1.
conduit wiring is one conduit wiring is used in damp situation. Two, in wiring light point neutral is controlled by switch. Three, in three pin plug maximum radius pin is used for phase. Four, in conduit wiring CTC wire is used. Five, leads sheathed wiring edge is more than conduit wiring. Activity 4. M. To familiarize the student with the electrical connection of a lamp to the supply mains. N. P. Single way switch. To select the proper size of connecting wires and switch for a given load. Related information. In a lamp, the electrical energy is converted into light. The function of the switch is to turn the lamp on or off by making and breaking the electrical circuit respectively. The switch should be connected to the phase wire of the supply. It should be connected in series switch the lamp. The function of the phase is to be protect an electrical circuit against over current which may be caused by a fault or overloading. Apparatus and materials. Apparatus and material. One lamp, two switch, three fuse, four wooden button, PVC button, five link clips, six screws, seven nails, eight insulation tape, nine connecting wires, 10 lamp holder, 11 electrician common hand tools. 11 electrician common hand tools required for all electrician. 11 electrician common hand tools. Precautions. 1. Make all the connection tight. 2. Check the rating of the fuse. Procedure. 1. Fix the switch and lamp holder on the board. 2. Connect the switch and lamp. 3. Connect the circuit of the supply mains switch. The main switch is off. 4. Put on the main switch. Activity 5. M. To check the connection of the lamp by one switch series apparatus lamp 100 watt 220 watt holders one way switch PVC wire 1/18 SWG etc. Tools and equipment serial number 1 particular specification quality 1 plier slide cutting plier combination plier 1 2 screwdriver 1 3 face tester 6 inch 1 procedure take a PVC 1/18 SWG wire about 1 meter in length and cut it in two pieces of equal length and with side cutting plier. Remove the insulations of nearly 1 cm of both ends of each wire with the help of combination plier. Now take the holder and screw the nut with the help of a screwdriver, fit each end of both the wire in the bolt and screw the nuts. Now cover the holder, connect one end of the wire to the top point of the switch, take 1 foot of another wire and connect it to the bottom of the switch. Connect the switch wire to face and another wire to neutral, switch it on. If the bulb glows, then our connection is right. Precaution 1. Face is always controlled by the switch. 2. Part of the wire with removed insulation should not be open. Twisted wire fitted in the holder should be put in such a way that the two wires should not touch each other. 4. Carefully remove the insulation part so that the wire should not cut. 5. Do not touch any necked electrical wire unless you are sure that there is no current in the wire. Activity 6. M. Check the connection of lamp by two switches parallel. Related information. The circuit consists of one lamp and one pair of two switches are connected. The common point in switches S1 and S2 are C1 and C2 respectively. The common point C2 is connected to position 2 of the switches S2. Now if the common C1 is connected to position 1 in switch S1, then the path of the electric circuit is not complete and hence the lamp will not glow. However, if C1 is connected to position 1, then the path of current is completed through S1, S2 and the lamp will glow. Apparatus 1. One lamp holder, pendant 5A 250 watt. 2. One lamp 40 watts 250 watt V. 3. Two-way switch 5A 250 V. 4. Connecting wires 5. Insulated pliers 6. Electrician knife 7. Screwdriver. How to control a lamp two different place by two-way switches. Procedure 1. Connect the lamp with the two switches S1 and S2. 2. Put the lamp in position in the holder. 3. Make the position 1 on S1 and 2 on S2. 4. Operate switch S1 in position 1 and 1. 5. For each position of S1, put switch S2 in position 2 and 2 respectively. 6. Observe the results. Precautions 1. All connections should be firmly made. 2. Switches S1 and S2 should be connected to the face wire. Check your progress. A. Fill in the blanks. 1. Distribution board is used for dividing an electrical power feed into 2. In an electric circuit, the positive side is connected to the and the switch is used to start the power supply. 3. Switches should be connected to the wire of supply. फॉर द प्रोटेक्ट्स एन इलेक्ट्रिक सर्किट. बी मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चन. वन स्विचेस होल्डर एंड सॉकेट आर फिक्स्ड ऑन बोर्ड्स. ए सनमाइका, बी आयरन, सी स्टील, डी कॉपर. टू इन अ लैंप इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी इज कन्वर्टेड इंटू इलेक्ट्रिक रेसिस्टेंस. सी लाइट, डी करंट. थ्री ऑल ब्रांच वोल्टेज आर सेम इन सर्किट. ए सीरीज, बी शंट, सी पैरेलल, डी इलेक्ट्रिकल. डी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन बोर्ड इज ऑल्सो नोन एज अ ए ब्रेकर पैनल, बी पैनल बोर्ड, सी इलेक्ट्रिकल पैनल, डी ऑल टाइप ऑल ऑफ दीज. सी शॉर्टर आंसर क्वेश्चन. शॉर्ट आंसर क्वेश्चन वन. शॉर्ट आंसर क्वेश्चन सी. शॉर्ट आंसर क्वेश्चन वन. सिल्वर इज गुड कंडक्टर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी बट इट इज रेयरली यूज्ड एज वायरिंग मटेरियल. वाई. टू राइट डाउन द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ कॉपर एंड एल्युमिनियम एंड अबाउट देयर एप्लीकेशन इन इलेक्ट्रिकल वायरिंग. थ्री एल्युमिनियम इज द मोस्ट कॉमनली यूज्ड मटेरियल फॉर इलेक्ट्रिकल वायरिंग. वाई. फोर लिस्ट द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ होल्डर्स. फाइव लिस्ट द डिसएडवांटेजेस ऑफ केसिंग कैपिंग वायरिंग. सिक्स विच मटेरियल इज यूज इन कंड्यूट वायरिंग. सेवन लिस्ट द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ कंड्यूट वायरिंग. एट राइट द कलर कोड ऑफ एसी पावर सर्किट फॉर सिंगल फेज सर्किट. सेशन थ्री वर्क प्लेस हेल्थ एंड सेफ्टी मेजर्स. सेशन थ्री वर्क प्लेस हेल्थ एंड सेफ्टी मेजर. वर्क प्लेस हजार्डस सिस्टम्स आर डिजाइंड टू प्रोटेक्ट द हेल्थ एंड सेफ्टी ऑफ वर्कर्स. इंफॉर्मेशन मस्ट बी प्रोवाइडेड अबाउट द सेफ हैंडलिंग यूजेस स्टोरेज एंड डिस्पोजल ऑफ हजार्डस सिस्टम. Workplace hazard is something that can have potential to harm the technician. There are hazards in every type of job and every type of workplace. Everyone at the workplace shares the responsibility to identify and control the hazards. The technician must first recognize the hazards at the workplace. When the technician installs or assembles the components, see he must have to face hazards which are related to the workplace. For instance, these hazards can be associated with the installation and assembly process of a water purifier. The technician should be aware of the hazards associated with the installation of a water purifier. Majority of the hazards can be avoided by being aware and taking appropriate precautions. Electrical hazards. An electrical hazard defines a dangerous condition. This dangerous condition is related to energized equipment or a conductor at workplace. If the technician comes in contact with the energized equipment, then the equipment may cause injury to the technician. There is a possibility of being electrocuted or getting an ARC flash burn, thermal burn or blast injury while assembling the component in a unit. Many of the hazards can be avoided by being aware and making appropriate precautions. This will ensure safety at workplace. Figure 3.22. This is figure 3.22. Safe work in an electrical system. Electricity, a great friend, a deadly enemy. Points that need to be remembered for working safety around electrical panel and cabinet are as follow. 1. Watch out for loose cords and wires. Loose cords and wires can cause physical hazards and even electrical hazards. Hazardous tape should be placed if a cord or a wire is placed on a pathway. Two, wear proper personal protective equipment. The kind of personal protective equipment PPE required around a machine will depend upon the type of machine and task the employee is performing. Nevertheless, gloves, hard hat, safety glasses, earplugs and other gears are important to use where necessary. For safety, signs can be posted near panels. Remaining employees to wear PPE. Figures 3.23 and 3.24. This is figure 3.23. Loose cord which can be hazardous. Figure 3.24. Hazardous tape. Use cautions around heat sources. Some panels and equipment get hot while operating. Everyone should be aware of these areas and use caution when nearby. PPE like gloves or flame resistance clothing may be required in these areas. 4. Be careful when cleaning around a panel or equipment. One should note other possible hazards too. Figure 3.24. Figure 2.24. Hazardous tape. Fire and explosion hazards. Need of PPP during cleaning. Risk of electric shock. Follow visual and written instructions panel. Equipment has signs and labels on them alerting employees to hazardous. Figure 3.25. Eye protection, safety, helmet, earplugs, high visibility clothing, figure 3.25, personal protection equipment, lists, safety, footwear, protective gloves, dust mask, eye protection. 5. Be cautious while testing, replacing the components in the panel. All levels of voltage should be considered equally dangerous. Even the voltage level which cannot produce electrical shocks should also not be ignored. We should check and confirm that the circuit is dead before touching it for repairing, maintenance or any other work. 6. Avoid water at all times when working with electricity. Never touch or try repairing any electrical equipment or circuits with wet hands. It increases the conductivity of electrical current. Figure 3.26. 7. Never use equipment with damaged insulation or broken plugs. 8. If you are repairing an electrical device, always turn off the main supply. Figure 3.26. Avoid water while working with electricity. 9. Always use insulated tools while working. 10. Always use appropriate insulated rubber gloves and goggles while working on any branch circuit or any other electrical circuit. 11. Never try repairing energized equipment. Always check that is de-energized first by using a tester. Chemical hazards are caused due to 1. Improper storage of chemicals causing a chemical leakage. 2. Mishandling of chemicals due to inadequate training or negligence. Fire extinguishers. A fire extinguisher, figure 3.27. This is figure 3.27. Ports of fire extinguisher. Hose, nozzle, pin and seal, gauge, inspection tag. Fire extinguisher. The fire extinguisher, figure 3.27, is a protection device used to seize fire. It is the basic first aid equipment which can be effectively used for controlling fire. A fire extinguisher is a cylindrical pressure vessel containing an agent which can be discharged to seize a fire. A fire extinguisher should always be available in areas where persons work with electrical equipment. Different parts of a fire extinguisher are shown in figure 3.27. The following steps demonstrate the operation of a fire extinguisher in case of fire energy emergency. Step 1. Identify this safety pin of the fire extinguisher, which is generally present in its handle. Step 2. Break the seal and pull the safety pin from the handle. Step 3. Use the fire extinguisher by squeezing the lever. Step 4. Sweep it from side to side. First aid for electrical emergencies. Electrical accidents cause countless injuries. Injury could be minimized and many lives saved if proper rescue techniques and treatments are used. Electrical accidents may occur at any time or place. timely response and treatment of victims is a major concern. When an electrical accident occurs due to the effect of misuse clamping, a victim is often incapable of moving or releasing the electrical conductor. Caution should be a primary consideration during any electrical accident or emergency. There should always be an emergency response plan for scheduled electrical maintenance or work. Electrical rescue technique. A. Approaching the accident. Never rush into an accident situation. Call 108 as soon as possible. Approach the accident place cautiously. Swollen tongue may obstruct airway. Vision problems, fractured bones, entry burn, irregular heartbeat or cardiac arrest, paralysis, exit burn, difficulty in breathing or respiratory arrest, muscles tenderness and possible twitching. Figure 3.28. Wireman in an unconscious state because of an electrical shock. B. Examining the scene. Visually examine victims to determine if they are in contact with energized conductors. Figure 3.28. This is figure 3.28. There is electricity in this wire and this electrician has touched this and fallen. This electrician is unconscious. Even he has touched, he is in condition of touching visually examine victims to determine if they are in contact with energized conductors. Figure 3.28. Metal surface objects near the victim may also be energized. Figure 3.29 and figure 3.29. Victim in contact with energized conductor. Figure 3.30. Use of non-conductive material to rescue the victim. You may become a victim of if you touch an energized victim or conductive surface. Do not touch the victim or conductive surface while they are energized. Switch off the electrical circuits if possible. C. Hazards and solutions. Be alert for hazards such as heated surfaces and fire, etc. In case you cannot switch off the power sources, take extreme care. Ensure that you hand and feel fit are dry. Wear protective equipment such as glove and shoes. Stand on a clean dry surface. Use non-conductive material to remove a victim from the conductor. Figure 3.30. D. High voltage rescue. Special training is required for rescue if high voltage is present. Protective equipment such as gloves and shoes must be worn. E. First aid. A victim may be required cardiopulmonary resuscitation CPR cardiopulmonary resuscitation CPR. Steps to perform in CPR are shown in figure 3.31 and 3.32 and 3.33. If the victim is breathing and has a heartbeat, give first aid for injuries and treat for shock. Ensure the victim gets medical care as soon as possible. Physician attending the victim must have detailed information to properly diagnose and care for the victim. The physician must determine whether the victim should be sent to a trauma or burn center. Figure 3.31, chest compression. Figure 3.32, open mouth for airway. 3.33, rescue breathing. This is rescue breathing. Check your progress. A. Fill in the blanks. 1. While working with the electricity, the technician must wear gloves and shoes. 2. Defective or inadequate insulation may result in. 3. CPR stand for. B. Multiple choice question. What are the steps to operate fire extinguishers? A. Identify the safety pin of the fire extinguisher, which is generally present in its handle. B. Break the seal and pull the safety pin from the handle. C. Use the fire extinguisher by squeezing the lever. D. All of the above. 2. When do you use a fire extinguisher? A. In case of flood. B. In case of electric shock. C. In case of fire. D. In case of burn injury. 3. Which of the following is a safety items that a wireman must not have while working? A. Safety boots. B. Gloves. C. Helmet. D. Belt. 4. Which of the following steps are required to perform CPR? A. Chest compression. B. Open airway. C. Rescue breathing. D. All of the above. Thanks for watching.